Hey, everybody. My name is Anna Dixon. I'm an applied research scientist at Dimagi. That means that I get to do like a really cool job, which is to take all the advancements in AI and machine learning, and I get to make them work in our space. And so Dimagi is a social enterprise that's been around for a couple decades. And what we do is we build digital health tools for use in low to middle income countries. And most of those tools go into the hands of frontline workers, but we also have some direct-to-user cases as well. And so our goal at Dimagi is to see that LLM technologies are spread equitably by making them work in native low-resource languages. And so this project was all about fine-tuning GPT-4o Mini and GPT-4o for health education chatbots in those low-resource Kenyan and Malawian languages. All right, so I'm going to introduce our use case. This was a project funded by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation, where we were going to use LLMs for family planning in Kenya and Senegal. Our project goal was to evaluate the efficacy of a conversational agent to support behavior change in family planning via changing knowledge, attitudes, and self-efficacy of young people. This is an architecture of our chatbot. The user message comes in and it hits the router LLM. Each one of these brain graph looking icons is a different instance of GPT-4. And the router sends the message to one of three support bots. We have a general conversationalist, a quiz bot, and a role playing bot. And then finally the response is sent back to the user. Now, one of the major project requirements was that it had to work in Sheng. So Sheng is a Swahili-English slang. It's a mashup between Swahili and English. There's some other languages mixed in there, as well as some slang words. And we do this so that we can be more relatable to the Kenyan youth. But this is really hard, right? Because the LLMs are pre-trained on data that's available to them, and these languages are just less available. So we started the project like most people do. We did zero-shot and few-shot prompting. But we found that it just didn't produce very good Sheng. And my native speaking teammates say that the Swahili English substitutions were really awkward, and the flow was just not what they expected. So we tried something else, where we injected more than 800 Sheng sentences from some partner source material into the prompt as a style guide. And what we found was that it achieved good Sheng, so we were pretty excited. But that's a lot of tokens to inject into your prompt, and so it was really slow. And it was really costly. And we also found out that the Sheng quality wasn't really robust to the conversation history and the prompt changes. So we shook it up and did something new. And this is the updated architecture. And everything on the left is the same, except for now we're telling all the instances of GPT-4 only respond in English. And at the very end, we funnel it through a new machine translation layer that translates from English into our target language. So this adds some modularity to the system, and there are a few benefits that come with it. The first is the obvious one, where we get to now isolate our development efforts. So now we can optimize for our health education chatbots, as well as for that machine translation layer, and then look at different languages as well. The second advantage was that we can now isolate our language quality evaluation. And that was really difficult before, and I'll talk a little bit more about that in a couple slides, because I think it's really interesting. And then finally, when you do instruction fine tuning, one of the risks is that the LLM becomes less good at other things. And so by keeping our scope very narrow to just the machine translation layer, for the fine tuning, we feel like we don't have to worry about that quite so much. The machine translation layer is really easily implemented just using the LLM chat completion endpoint. So you're going to send in your input messages. This is the system prompt that I used. You are a machine translation bot. Whenever the user enters text, translate the text from English to the target language. Only respond with the translation. If you can't translate the text, just say none. Return only the translation. Do not return additional explanation. So those of you who have iterated on your prompts are laughing. I am as well. One of the models was a bit verbose and always wanted to explain its translation to us. So then the user message will be the text to translate. And finally, we'll send it to the GPT-4 chat completion endpoint, and the assistant reply should be the translated text. But now that we have a way to implement it, we need to know if it worked. So that's when we get to the evaluation part. And to start, you'll build your evaluation dataset, which for us is just a CSV file of sentence pairs. So one column is your input, your English sentence, and the other column is just going to be your ground truth translation. And for each one of those sentence pairs, you're going to send your input into your system and generate the candidate translation. And now, for each one of those candidate translations, we need a way to measure how well it's doing. So that enters into the BLEU metric, which is a very commonly used machine translation metric. And I really had to resist the urge, actually, to put a math equation up here, but I realized that I didn't have 10 minutes to just talk through that. So instead, I'm going to tell you that, approximately speaking, it's a measure of how well the tokens match between the candidate translation and the ground truth translation. The things that you might want to know are that it is on a scale from 0 to 100, with a higher score, meaning that it's a better translation, and a score of about 40 is typically considered to be pretty good. Some other tidbits, if you were tackling this issue yourself, is that at a sentence level, BLEU is not very good. It's more good on a large data set. BLEU is also dependent on multiple parameters and the tokenizer selection. So if you're comparing your metric between papers, for example, you may not be comparing the same things. And so to get over that, to keep a standard metric working within our team, we adopted using the SacroBLEU package. It's really great. I highly recommend it. And it has just some standard BLEU metrics there ready for you to use. So we use the Flores 200 SP BLEU metric, which is developed by the Facebook AI research team for the No Language Left Behind initiative. And it's sort of developed with this purpose in mind. So we decided that that was a really good one to go with here. OK, cool. Now we finally get to go through some fine tuning now that we've set up our problem really well. So we're going to use instruction fine tuning. And instruction fine tuning, if you don't know, is the idea that you're giving a model the same instruction over and over and over again. And you're just trying to fit the model to that instruction so that it can do a good job. And so we're going to make this fine tuning data set. We wrote some Python scripts. And the Python script simply constructs a JSON-L file where each line represents the model completing a machine translation task for one of those ground truth translations. So I'm going to walk through it, and you're going to pretend like each one of these columns is a line in the JSON-L file. It's really hard to get all this up on a slide. But you'll start with these messages that you'll send in. So these are the messages that you would send through the system, and this is the responses you would expect to see. The first message is the system prompt, you're a machine translation bot, ... That's going to be the same prompt that you saw previously. I recommend using the same prompt during training as an inference. And then we'll have the user text, which is the English sentence that goes in. And finally, the assistant reply, which is one of those ground truth translations. So you upload the JSON-L file, and it's literally one line of code, if you're using the OpenAI API Python package, to start a fine-tuning job. And then if you're anything like me, you open up the playground, and you sort of watch your error curve go down, because it's extremely gratifying. And what we found was that fine-tuning actually improved the Sheng translation quality quite a bit. So we had 1,300 domain-specific sentences translated by the native-speaking speakers on our team. And we did an 85-15% split, so left 15% of our data out as a holdout. And GPT-40-Mini achieved a 22.21 SP BLEU score. And then when we fine-tuned GPT-40-Mini, we increased that score to 65.23. So it was pretty significant. And we have just kicked off another project funded by the Bill and Melinda Gates Foundation as well to explore this idea in several other languages. And so these results are extremely preliminary, but we've been looking at Chichewa, which is a language spoken by approximately 10 million people, predominantly in Malawi. And we generated 554 simple sentences from another LLM from a suggested list of topics and had it translated by professional translators. So GPT-40-Mini started with an 18.45 SP BLEU score. Fine-tuned GPT-40-Mini doubled that to 39.46. GPT-40, the base model, did 44.62, so a little bit better. And then more recently, GPT-40 became available for fine-tuning, so we threw that one in as well and got 47.40, and it's doing a little bit better. And honestly, at first I was a little bummed because I'm looking at it and I'm like, oh, before we did the fine-tuned GPT-40. GPT-4 was doing better than the fine-tuned GPT-4 Mini, but if you think about it, they're kind of pretty comparable, which is really exciting because it's a tenth of the cost to inference. So on the right, you see a box plot. We're also working with the translators to make sure that the BLEU scores line up with the accuracy ratings, so doing a little bit of human validation. And we've also been having quite a bit of luck looking into open source data sets and leveraging those for both our evaluation and for training. And so you can check those out there if you would like. Thank you very much, both you and my team.